And yeah, there are movies on here that are even worse. Number 6, That's My Boy. What's up? Adam Sandler. And I'm a guy that actually likes Adam Sandler because I have a lot of his CDs and I liked all the versions of the Hanukkah song. This movie was just so freaking gross and raunchy. It was so freaking terrible. I hated this movie. Oh my God. And anybody who likes this movie, you have the worst taste in films whatsoever. Oh my God. Because I actually saw some people saying, hey, that's my boy, he's like the favorite movie of the year. No, it's fucking awful. And you have a bad taste in films. Oh my God. It was just so bad. Number 5. Paranormal Activity 4. Oh my God. This is like the worst found footage film I've seen entirely this year. And one of the worst horror films ever. There are a couple scary scenes, but really, it's just fucking horrible. The most this movie did for me was that it got me interested enough to see the first three films, which were pretty decent, with number 3 being the best of the three. But this movie is just fucking terrible. If I was a fan of the Paranormal Activity franchise, after seeing number 4, I would say, I'm done! I don't give a shit about what Paranormal Activity movie is coming afterwards. I am never seeing another Paranormal Activity movie again. And that's exactly true. I am never going to see another Paranormal Activity movie. I don't care about the fact that we got 2 movies coming out this year from that franchise. Fuck them. And I'm anxiously awaiting the Haunted House movie that Marlon Wayans is coming out that's supposed to parody this franchise. Because I think that movie looks pretty funny to me. And I know some people who have seen the trailer say that it doesn't look, it looks freaking terrible. But I think it looks very funny, and I hope it does the franchise well enough to really make fun of it. Because after seeing Paranormal Activity 4, I want to see a parody of this fucking franchise. Number 4. Okay, here we get the movies that where I was giving a 1 out of 10 to. Red Dawn. Oh my God, Chris Hemsworth. How can Thor end up in a bad movie like this? Where you got this, probably one of the worst uses of shaky cam, where you're told that people die because from an invasion from North Korea into the United States, and you don't know who dies and who lives very well, and his co-actor here, Joss Peck, ends up being his replacement when Chris Hemsworth's character dies. Like, what? Chris Hemsworth dies and Joss Peck takes over this goofball from Nickelodeon? Oh my God! I mean, yes, I understand Joss Peck is trying to change his image. That's great. But this is not the way to do it. Number 3 is one of the biggest pieces of conservative bullshit I've ever seen in my life. Won't Back Down. This is such a terrible movie. This advertises itself as a teacher and a parent standing together to change education for the better of the kids. But what it is, it's these two are trying to create a movement to turn public schools into charter schools. Charter schools are Wall Street schools. They are schools that are creating conformity. They're not educating minds. It is the exact opposite. This does not address the real problems that teachers have with education. It doesn't address the fact that teachers have to buy their own supplies in order to teach kids because the schools don't give them enough supplies. It doesn't address the fact any problems with the MCAS tests or how the need for extracurricular activities, which Here Comes the Boom, which is a good movie but not a great film, does very well. It has too many cliches from Stand By Me, Dangerous Minds, but it's a really bad film. Oh my God, it's fucking awful. It totally makes me lose faith in Maggie Gyllenhaal, Viola Davis. These two actresses I really admire a lot, and I'm starting to wonder if there's any real standing behind anything they believe in, or they just do whatever role they do and don't even put any real passion behind it. I'm starting to wonder. Number two, The Apparition, probably the worst horror film I've ever seen for this year. And I know if I saw Piranha 3 Double D, it probably would have gotten number one, but I skipped it because I don't even want to bother to watch a movie that I know will end up number one. I want to just like happen on number one by accident, or go out to see a movie that I know is going to be bad and put it on the worst list of number one. But Apparition, oh my god, what a fucking horrible movie. Sebastian Stan, Ashley Green, and Draco Malfoy, Tom Felton. I feel sorry for Sebastian Stan and Draco Malfoy. I don't feel so bad for Ashley Green, so I don't think I don't like her that much as an actress, even though she did very well in Eclipse. I mean, it's just freaking terrible that all you have is a girl running around in underwear trying to get away from this ghost, and the idea that, oh, if you believe in this ghost, it'll kill you is not even in the fucking movie. And they blow the whole movie in the fucking trailer and the goddamn poster. It's just freaking awful. But number one, with the CGI baby and the fucking vision in Michael Sheen's head and Jacob falling in love with a 12-year-old girl, however old Renesmee is, and bad acting from vampires, Twilight, Breaking Dawn 2. My god, is this a horrible franchise. The fact that I sat through all five movies, and yeah, the other reviews for those movies are coming out soon. Oh my god! And what I did was I rented the first three, because I already saw Breaking Dawn 1 in the theaters at the cheap theater when it came out, that in the West Boylston areas, just so I could put it on my worst list. I mean, seriously, what the fuck? And I'm very concerned about the fact that we got Saoirse Ronan, who is an excellent actress in the movie like The Host, and this Warm Bodies shit that's coming out soon too this year. I'm hoping those two movies aren't going to be that bad, but they look pretty bad to me. But yeah, that's my worst list for 2012. So let's flush that list down the toilet. And that is it for 2012.